In this problem, we have a semi-batch reactor that's isothermal. We have two reactions in parallel. And we're given the amounts that initially are in the reactor of A and B and the initial volume. We start feeding additional A into the reactor. And the question is, after 4 hours of reaction, what are the concentrations of D and E? So we're going to have to do mass balances. First, I'm going to pause and draw a figure to represent the system. It's always good to have a figure to make sure we know what is known, what is unknown for this problem. So here I've drawn a representation of the semi-batch reactor we're feeding in A. What we want to be able to do is determine the amount of A at a later time, so we're going to need rate of reaction of A by each of the reactions. So the rate of reaction of A in the first reaction is related to the rate that D forms if we divide these by their stoichiometric coefficients. This is 1 and this is -2. Likewise, for the second reaction, the rate that A forms in the second reaction is related to the rate that E forms. It's -1 for a reactant, +3 for a product. And so we can then use these expressions here to write down the mass balance for A. So the mass balance for A, a semi-batch reactor, change in the total number of moles, that's N sub A, capital N, respect to time, is due to the fact that we have A flowing into reactor, so this is the molar flow rate, moles per time of A coming in, 20 moles per hour. There's no A leaving, so that term would be 0. And then we have the rate of reaction of A by the first reaction times the volume, the rate of reaction of A second reaction times the volume. And so this is FA0. We just written down -2 times the rate of D times the volume. And then -1/3 the rate of E times the volume. So now let's substitute in the numerical values for these terms on the right side of the equation using rates of reaction and the flow rates. So let me point out a couple of things. One, I did not substitute for volume because the volume's changing in a semi-batch reactor. We're adding more A to the system, so volume's going to be a function of time. And then I've indicated the units, so you can see when we put in volume, we're going to have units of moles per hour for each of the terms. So I can simplify this expression. All I've done is arithmetic, but now notice I've made this substitution that Ca times V is in A. So we've actually eliminated volume from this equation. We can separate variables. We just have an equation in terms of NA and T. We can separate variables and integrate this. Now I'm going to also write down the mass balances for components D and E. And this is basically an initial value problem, differential equations. And for most cases, I would just solve this numerically in something like polymath, 3 differential equations. I'm going to go through the analytical solution here just to give you an idea of the approach, but as things get more complicated, we basically have to do this numerically. So I've written down the equation with the variables separated and the integration limits, and so at t equals 0, I need to know the value of Na0. Well, that's Ca0 times volume, and we're given both of these values. So now I can integrate and end up with 1 over to 0.70 times the log of this denominator. And this is going to be evaluated between the two limits, Na0 and Na. The right side is just T. So I can simplify this. I'll substitute in the limits first. And so now I'm going to take the exponential of both sides of this equation. And of course, now I can rearrange this and solve for Na. So this tells me Na is a function of times. I can now determine, for example, 4 hours, the number of moles of Na, and I can determine the concentration. But what I want is the other components, I need to write mass balances for D. Let's do that one first. Change in the number of moles of D in the reactor with time is the rate reaction of D times the reactor volume. And this is plus 0.20 times the concentration of A times the volume. So this is 0.20 times the number of moles of A. And we calculated that down here. So we have an expression where, again, we can separate variables and integrate. We need the initial conditions. Well, the number of moles of D initially is equal to 0. And so this is now a differential equation that we can separate variables and solve. So I've made the substitution. I can do the multiplication now. Keep in mind when I'm doing these multiplications, I'm actually carrying more significant figures in the calculator than I'm writing down here. So when I look at the answer, it's not just multiplying 0.2 times 28.6, but it's whatever the number of significant figures that were in the calculator. So now I can substitute my limits from 0 to 4 hours in D0 is 0, and I want to determine the number of moles after 4 hours. So I can do this integration. So substituting in, doing the multiplication, I determine the number of moles of D. I can do the same thing for E, and I won't go through those calculations. If I do that, number of moles of E is equal to 128.8 moles. Again, it's the same exact type calculation as I did for E. But I want the concentration, so I need the volume. So the volume after 4 hours, so this is at 4 hours, the volume is going to be my initial volume, plus the volumetric flow rate times time. Since the volumetric flow rate's constant, this is 5 cubic meters, and we're adding 1 cubic meter per hour and 4 hours. So our volume after 4 hours is 9 meters cubed. So the concentration of D is the number of moles over the volume after 4 hours. So here are the values that we're asked to calculate. What are the concentration after 4 hours? We might want to reduce this to 2 significant figures based on what's given in the problem statement.